purple flashlight.
Paper that I should be working on the live set, so I started working on Assistant Performer, which is the application that I have that allows me to do the live set. I've been developing, aiming at doing live sets with. One thing that it was missing was a proper README file on information how to install it, which I added today. Create how to install, the problems that you get with MIDI dependency. It's particularly nasty. It requires Visual Studio, and when we install Visual Studio, the 2015 Community Edition doesn't come with C++ and Windows 8.1 SDK, so you need to install those manually. And yeah, I also described a little bit of the architecture. It's still very rough and this is still very alpha assisted performer in general. The documentation reflects that a little bit. I want to improve it. But I've been too busy with other stuff. I guess I could increase the version a little bit. But yeah, still miles away from being ready for the general public, but it is open source, so it's a work in progress, and whoever wants to use it for other stuff is free to use it for other stuff. Right now it only has the few examples that we did for the Plunk Festival and for the demo beat. And there are some YouTube links to that. I should probably add that to the readme as well, like examples of stuff done. Although I don't think I actually have a video for that, but I do have a video for the demo bit. PS Wild entry. Okay, here it is.
Into a thick, dark cloud.
So this one at least. Demo bit. And at some point I should do some tutorial videos as well. Project examples. Yeah, Plunk, maybe there's a link. Festival Arctica. Yeah, so this site is not very intuitive. I think it's all. Where the hell is it? Fucking hell, what the hell is it? Dika underwater performance. Oh, we have, yeah, I wrote a blog about it at Arctica website, so I guess this might be actually the best link to show it. Yeah, okay, so I'll just link to this. Okay, so yeah, that's what I've been doing on today on Assisted Performer. Still have a lot of stuff that needs to get done before this is useful. I have a list of issues of things that I want to get done as well. I have an example with the accelerometers of the smartphone, controlling parameters, doing a multi-part configuration for the audio, doing some basic usage tutorials, which is probably still too soon to do. Do some basic documentation. I started on that today. Do an example of voting, because right now each person controls one parameter, and what I want to be able to also do is at some point do a call for people to vote, either, you know, option A or option B, and count the votes and use that as output to the system. And I need to do an example page for that and incorporate that to the live set, because actually I want that on my live set itself, so to give people the option to choose if I, you know, if you want to go faster or go slower or stuff like that. So it would be cool to have that as an actual example to show. And yeah, some other things pending here. So still a lot of work to be done on Assisted Performer. I sometimes work at it at work itself, because it's a project for work. And other times I work it on my days off to do my own artistic stuff. So right now I also added a new effect, which I showed you guys. These canvas tests actually just loads the main page. It's actually, why is it cutting back? I think I need to fix something here. No, font size. Yeah, it's the usual problem. It's either has one too many or one too little. Yeah, then it pops, and I want to do the other way around. I wanted to always have one more. Same with on the right side. So I think if I just do here plus one and here plus one, it should fix itself. Yeah, okay, this looks a bit better. So yeah, I did this new effect, and the idea is that we have this canvas and we have a series of effects that can be used as layers, and I actually hot coded them that I can turn them on and off. And the idea is to have a lot of effects, different ones with a lot of tweakable parameters, and then define the effect itself here and what parameters can be controlled, and then have actually a structure where you say, okay, scene one has these effects toggled on. So usually the timers are on all of the effects, on all of the scenes. Then this first scene, the one that I was just testing, only has this new effect that I just made called background characters. The second scene has a background, the usual background and the pink spiral. Then the third scene has the red stars and the pink spiral. So this is the sequence of scenes happening. Right now I was just working on background characters just to try a new effect. I wanted just to have some characters that you have on the UTF character set. I wanted to have them just showing on the background, maybe do a sine wave thingy, which was what I did. And I think I might try some other stuff with this later, to do some more different kind of effects. I'm not quite sure exactly what just yet, but yeah, it was just a test while I was waiting for the Visual Studio stuff to finish working. So yeah, I think that's it for today. I'm gonna edit this as a video and put it up on YouTube in case anyone is curious. So if you have any questions or whatever about Assistant Performer or this new series of videos that I started doing of me trying to do stuff that is somehow productive, feel free to ask. And yeah, so bye bye, take care.